We got a new Imkevin, YUJI's Redemption Arc.
So these last few weeks, I know I probably came off as a YUJI hater. Now, I wouldn't say I'm a hater. It's just with his debut one-on-one match, losing to a range type, a support class is crazy to me. But y'all said let him cook, so I let him cook. And with this episode, he definitely cooked. So it begins right where he left off, and I don't know who Mahito feeling like covering the city.
If you didn't see my last reaction, I reacted to the thing they did before this. The section he talked about before this. So we catching up. It's the next installment.
Like that, because bro.
By the way, the 23rd, this Saturday, me and 6 Seconds are dropping Get Your Lick Back on the Scru Face Jean YouTube channel. Make sure y'all is checked in for that, because it's about to be a moment. Bars, bro.
You are not Venom. You're not an Avengers level threat. So that's when Mahito started yelling at YUJI, telling him to try harder. Told our boy to change his sensitivity. Toto laughed and was like, hold on, nigga. I'm in the lobby too. Then YUJI looks over like, yo, bro, we finna jump him or what? Duh. Did you forget what show this is? He switched YUJI with Mahito, held him down while YUJI came through with a spin kick. But he ended up twisting his own head off and his body went into autopilot. Meanwhile, Mahito was over here having the time of his life cosplaying as Mike Wazowski. So he went.
This nigga is it. This turned into Ridley Scott, didn't it?
Back to normal, made this monster to go box with Toto. And look at this dude.
Scott, the one who did it, John Carpenter. I'm stupid. Not Ridley Scott. Ridley Scott's Alien. Let me redo that joke. This shit got real John Carpenter, didn't it? God damn. Okay. Pretend I didn't say Ridley Scott. Sin City was
amazing. Oh. That was the most calmest weave I ever seen. Woo! He saw how y'all did not me on Twitter and wanted the same treatment. And he had to look back to make sure everyone saw that shit too. Fast. So then he switched places with the monster. The counterfeit Mahito was trying to put YUJI in a montage, but Toto switched him with the real Mahito. And that boy spawned into a meme block stream. Then it goes back to Toto, and the moment he weaved, I was like, oh, this is light work. Never mind, he shut me up immediately. I didn't think that nigga had hands for real. Then he brought his arm back to a whole different country for this gut punch. But it wasn't finished. Threw Toto into a building playing pinball with his body. Then it came from the top ropes. Toto dodged, then we might gotta call him John Wick, cause he picked up a random ass hanger and turned it into Kung Lao's hat. But that was just a diversion. I didn't know Toto was a Naruto fan, but after doing that move right here, it was confirmed. Then he hit him with a
miss the dude, turn into the hanger, and that clap effect where he switches spot, that's almost like a bar. That hit me like I just heard a nasty bar.
The devastating left. Woo! Laid his ass out with one punch. Then he looks over his shoulder and his ops is just standing there. He really had them waiting in line for their ass beating. So now we're back to YUJI, and Mahito is getting excited because he finally gets to run the ones without getting jumped. So he ended up using these worms to knock YUJI into his building. And tell me how it transitioned from him about to get bodied to him throwing a whole billboard. If you're ever fighting YUJI, at this point it's a guarantee that something heavy will be hurtling at your neck. So then he leaps into the air trying to hit Mahito with a drop kick, but he blocked it and tossed him into
this animation is so A1, bro.
To a different arena, and I bet Mahito was enjoying the thrill of not getting jumped, but his smile instantly faded when he saw that Toto was chilling on the block. At this point, Mahito realized that the only way he can beat Toto is by using his domain. But he remembered the last time he used his domain when YUJI was around. Sukuna was not having it. That's when it clicked. He remembered a 0.2-second domain Gojo pulled out his ass and was like, shit, I might as well try it. He used his domain and Toto instantly expanded his simple domain. But obviously he gotta check in with Sukuna before walking in his hood. And Mahito was on a different type of timing, because he pulled up and was like, yeah, I'm finna murk either door before you can do something about it. And Sukuna just looked at him like, yeah, I gave a total of zero fucks of what he was saying. Now we're back and he wasted no time to put Toto in his optics. Luckily he was able to cut his own arm off, because that would have been back to the lobby for him. But his arm went rogue and started shooting projectiles. Then Mahito was like, back a little nigga, went straight after Toto. Not gonna lie, I thought Black Flash was like a super move. I thought there was a cooldown timer, but nah, they out here using it like it's a Rasengan. Good think Toto was able to focus his cursed energy into his core, or he probably would have had a donut in his stomach. But when Mahito started rushing in and Toto's necklace snapped, I ain't gonna lie, I thought it was GG's. And when it opened and that music started playing, bro, I was getting ready to break something. But turns out Toto really just put him in a genjutsu, and with no surprise, they is jumping his ass. So then he clapped Mahito's hand, switched places with Yuji, and fed him another black flash. See, now I realize that plot armor does exist, but it's only for the...
That boy slapped his own, gave him five. That boy gave him dap. Don't ever give me dap into a punch. That's so disrespectful. Don't ever dap me into a punch, bro. God damn.
Curses, because how does eating a knuckle sandwich give you a power boost? So he ended up transforming to whatever this form is called, and they started sprinting towards each other. Yuji went for a kick, Mahito grabbed it and tried to stab him, but Yuji must have played Sekiro because he got the Makiri counter unlocked. So then they both went in, Yuji blocked the jab, went in for the body shot, but turns out Mahito took a trip to Wakanda. His body must be vibranium because Yuji didn't leave a scratch. Then Mahito was like, oh yeah, you're cooked, buddy. Yuji blocked the punch, but Mahito spawned a sword out of his elbow, nearly took his head off. Then they ran back into the mix, and this choreography looks extravagant. I try to slow it.
I'm trying to tell you, bro, the choreography of this show be different level, bro. Oh, God in heaven. Somebody told me that they actually take a lot of the inspiration of their fights from Dragon Ball. Did they say that somewhere? Because there do be some Dragon Ball-esque things, but I ain't gonna lie. Let's keep it real. Dragon Ball Super's animation choreography is so much better than the old Dragon Ball Z. I think it's so unfair sometimes when people look at the older Dragon Ball Z and be like, well, the choreography is not as good. It's not, yeah, bro, no choreography was that good back then. You feel me? Come on, you got to take it as it is. Now, if you want to compare the new choreography, go to Super and go here. I still think Jujutsu Kaisen and Naruto have the best fight choreography, but I would say Jujutsu Kaisen is a bit more creative. Like, there's things I'm seeing. Niggas is hitting niggas with worms. I mean, I guess that happens in Naruto kind of too. But it's way more unique. This is a way more... I ain't never seen fighting like this.
Choreography looks extravagant. I tried to slow it down, like, but honestly, I didn't know what was going on. So then Mahito put the extended clip...
Of course, the punching and kicking is... There's only but so much you could do with punching and kicking. Like, punching and kicking gonna look the same no matter... What if you watching UFC or Dragon Ball Z? It don't matter. Now it's the powers that make it all unique.
Clip on his elbow, but Yuji simply moved his head a centimeter to the left. He ran in trying to give him a 50 piece, but the vibranium was doing his job. Mahito put his arms out on everything because he knew he was like that. So he used the extended clip once again, and this time it clipped his cheek. Then proceeds to smack him with his tail, leaps through the smoke, and put all five fingers on his face and body slam him through the ground. This is when Yuji realized the only way he can win is to hit him with a maximum energy black flash. And right when he was getting ready to square up, I guess his body reached his limits. Mahito noticed that was not gonna let the opportunity slip, but turns out the black flash he ate earlier has a bad aftertaste. Yuji took that time to force restart his leg and was ready.
That boy got a Charlie horse. He's like, God damn it. You know that tingling feeling your leg gets?
For the final round, Mahito stomped on the ground, putting him underwater. Yuji got into the gone stance and everything. Mahito came through with the flank, but Yuji's weave game was on point, and he was about to hit him with the meanest whiff punish, but he was lucky enough to escape. But seeing this scene right here reminded me of Luffy versus Bellamy. And with the way that fight went down, I knew Mahito was cooked. So they both went in for a punch. Yuji deflected his fist and was about to connect, but Mahito changed that side of his body, and I got no clue why he did that. But you know Mahito had to use that elbow again, and he was bringing that attack from the earth's bowels. But Yuji wasn't going to give him the chance. That's when Toto got up and broke that nigga neck on a severe level. Then he...
Yo, so is his arm really... His hand really is cut off now?
Turned around, and Yuji gave that man the craziest black flash. That's when Mahito noticed that he got no more transfigured humans in his duffel. And to be honest, I do think Yuji's a cool character, but if he's gonna start acting like this from now on, he just might get the main character title back. He was like, yeah, you know what, I am like you, I just didn't want to.
He ripped his mouth. That is gruesome. This is goddamn turned into Mortal Kombat.
Admit it, but shit's different now. Your ass finna
shook. Hold on, let me tell you something.
I am like you. I just didn't want to admit it, but shit.
I ain't never seen such a... This nigga is shook. But this is in the dictionary, in the Webster's definition of shook. This should be the picture next to it. Ain't no such thing as halfway crook. Scared to death, you scared to look, you shook. This nigga, God damn, he going out bad.
Woo! It's different now. Your ass finna die. Leave the country, I'm going to kill you. Change your identity, I'm going to kill you. If you're born again, I'm going to kill you. Yo, he really had his dude terrified. He was scared to the point where he imagined himself as a rabbit getting chased by a wolf. And you know it's bad when you're running with all your energy while Yuji is simply walking and still keeping up with you. So he ended up breaking his foot, turned
around. Yo, who the villain in this? Who the villain? Who the good guy? What the hell? Seem like my man over here, the villain. Seem like my man right here, the good guy.
Around and saw Yuji looking down on him.
Oh, he turned into Jason Voorhees, eh?
Then Mahito started tweaking out, throwing mud at him, and Yuji did not care. But the moment he caught a mud ball to the head, he said, I know you ain't just. He definitely missed his first punch on purpose because all he wants to do is bully. So Mahito was crawling on the ground, and I was like, ain't no way, bro. That better not be who I think it is. But it was. Ghetto came to save him. Now, since Ghetto is here, where is Mei Mei? Last time we saw her, she was getting ready to box with Ghetto. But real quick, let's get a round of applause for Yuji. I didn't expect this out of him, but he's probably gonna get humbled by Ghetto next episode. So let's enjoy it while it lasts.